As the 1820s ended, the Mexican government became concerned about the growing American influence in Texas. It feared an American plot to acquire the territory. In April 1830, the Mexican government passed a law that stopped immigrants coming to Texas from the United States and ended further land grants to Americans. Anglo-American settlers in Texas were alarmed by Mexico's action. The prosperity of many of them depended upon continued growth in trade with the United States. Stephen F. Austin tried to negotiate on behalf of the Texans with the Mexican leaders, but he soon realized that serious damage had already occurred in relations between the Texas settlers and the Mexican government. Those Texans concerned about relations with Mexico called a convention to discuss reforms. 58 delegates assembled in San Felipe on October 1, 1832. Stephen Austin was elected president of what became known as the Convention of 1832. The convention delegates resolved that Texas be made a separate Mexican state and that immigration from the United States be permitted again. However, their resolutions were never presented to the Mexican officials. A few months later, another group of Anglo-American colonists concerned with the situation in Texas called a second convention at San Felipe on April 1, 1833. The delegates adopted resolutions like those adopted at the previous convention. They called for Texas to be made a separate Mexican state, but this time they went a step further, actually drawing up a constitution for the proposed Mexican state of Texas. Stephen Austin was chosen to deliver the new resolutions to the Mexican government in Mexico City. He accepted the assignment to go to the Mexican capital. Traveling alone, Austin soon left San Felipe and began the 1,000-mile-long trip to Mexico City. Austin arrived in Mexico City 3 months later. He soon realized that the city was in deep trouble. Mexico City was ravaged by a severe cholera epidemic. The disease brought much suffering and death to thousands of residents. The city's woes led to the stalling of his mission. In addition to the epidemic, Austin faced a Mexican government in chaos. General Antonio López de Santa Anna had recently come to power as Mexico's president. However, upon Austin's arrival, Santa Anna's new government was not yet well organized. No plans had been made for dealing with the question of Texas, and Santa Anna himself was away from the city. Austin waited impatiently through October. Discouraged by his lack of accomplishments, Austin wrote a letter to authorities in San Antonio. In the letter, he described the difficulties he faced and suggested that Texans form a temporary state government. By November 1833, the situation in Mexico City seemed more hopeful. Santa Anna finally had returned to the capital and agreed to some of the reforms Austin requested. The Mexican president did not grant Texas separate statehood. He was willing, however, to repeal the law restricting immigration from the United States and also agreed to improve the court and postal systems. Pleased with the work that he had done in Mexico City, Austin left the capital on December 10th to return home. In January 1834, Austin reached the city of Saltillo in northern Mexico. Meanwhile, Mexican officials read the letter Austin had written to the authorities in San Antonio. They believed that Austin's statement that a new state government be formed was an act of rebellion. They ordered his arrest in Saltillo. Austin was held prisoner and transported back to Mexico City under guard. Austin remained in prison in Mexico City for 1 year. While confined, he wrote to family and friends, and in his journal, he recorded his prison experiences. February 13th, Mexico City, where I was. Shut up in the dark dungeon number 15 and not allowed communication with anyone. February 15th, I was permitted to walk with a guard in the yard, alone, to take exercise. I asked for books, but was not permitted to have any. March 2nd, 1834. I obtained today a book, a tale called Yes and No. I prefer bread and water with books to the best of eating without them. In a dungeon, the mind and thoughts require food more than the body. Local officials in various Texas towns pressed for Austin's freedom. They wrote to Mexican officials requesting that Austin be released. Two Texas lawyers went to Mexico City to help. Finally, on Christmas Day, 1834, Mexican authorities agreed to release the prisoner on bail. Austin was required to stay in Mexico City and wait for the final decision on his case. On July 11, 1835, Austin was given his complete freedom. He traveled to the port city of Veracruz and left for Texas by ship. When Austin arrived in Texas on September 1, 1835, he had been away for nearly 2.5 years. Austin returned to a troubled Texas. During Austin's imprisonment in Mexico, conflict had erupted between Mexican officials and some Texas settlers over the payment of taxes. Acting on Santa Anna's orders, Mexican officials demanded the arrest and trial of those Texans believed to be disloyal. Austin thought long and hard about what to do. Finally, believing that Santa Anna was out to crush Texas, Austin called for action, urging Texans to unite. He said, "War is our only recourse. There is no other remedy. We must defend our rights, ourselves, and our country by force of arms."